now see how God intends to fill his world. Three times you will see the word multiply. And 10 times you will see the word after its kind, after its type. So immediately you will understand God's method of growth is multiplication. Secondly, you realize God's method of growth is multiplying your after your kind. A certain bird produces birds like itself, but more than itself. Let's say one bird produces 10 baby birds. 10 baby birds each produce 10. So after one generation, you got 10, next generation, you have 100. And that way you will fill the earth very fast. Now, this is a seed truth. That's how God grows things. But I think a lot of Christians, and definitely a lot of churches, have never figured out God's method. For many churches, this is how they grow their church. What they do is, they have a rally, they use their great event, maybe a great preacher, a great drama, a great opportunity like Christmas, and they invite friends in, and some people get saved, and then we've added to the church 10 more this year. And that's why church growth is so slow. God doesn't want us to do addition. You almost think that pastors don't know the difference between addition and multiplication. Multiplication is God's method. So it's not like one pastor adds a few people in, but each believer in the New Testament, we are told, go and make disciples. Disciple making of all people. In other words, I'm a pastor. How do I multiply myself? I'm a pastor, so I must clone. I must produce pastors. So my role is, when I die, I hope I have produced 10 pastors like me, preferably better than me. And then I've taught these 10 pastors, each one to make 10 pastors themselves. And so you see, in by the first generation, PC has multiplied himself 10 times. And then by the next generation, his spiritual grandchildren will be 100 of them. Now, can you see how fast that is? So if you're a Sunday school teacher, you multiply yourself. One good Sunday school teacher, now you have 5 good Sunday school teachers. Each one of them taught what you taught them, and they learn how to teach others and make disciples of others. So 1, 5, 25. See? So how fast it can grow. If you're a cell group leader, 1, 5, 25. How fast, right? By the 4th, 5th generation, we have grandchildren, great-grandchildren. It's like a lot. So if you're just a friendly Christian, you know how to share the gospel in your office, you multiply your friendliness and others can do it. So basically, that's God's method. Very, very simple, but I think we've confused the plus and the multiplication process. What else do we learn? We learn that man is made in God's image. So in many ways, we are like God. But we must also remember, in many ways, we are not like God. We cannot create, for example. But we have the ability to have a creative mind like God. In many ways, unlike animals. Animals don't have a creative mind. A bird's nest from the time of Adam to now looks the same. A bird's nest is a bird's nest. It looks the same. Human house, from Adam's time to now, so much more addition and more beautiful, right? So we have a lot of ability in the image of God. On the other hand, we're also limited. So we are made in the image, but not exactly. Secondly, of course, sin defaced a lot of our image of God in each of us, right? So there are other truths that we can see. For example, originally man was supposed to eat the herb of the ground, vegetables. Today we all, after all the nutrition studies, we realize, hey, you know what's really good for us, our health? Vegetables. You know what's the best? Organic vegetables straight from the ground. That's the best. Well, a lot of nutrition study went into all this to realize that's the original food designed for us. Obviously, that was the best formula, God-given formula for sustaining our life. So what have you seen in Genesis chapter 1? You've seen actually God. How awesome He is. Wow, just speaks, it is done. The power of God is amazing, right? We see how orderly He is. He does things three. Separation here. Put things on. Very organized. Very orderly. We see God's very creative. Wow. All kinds of animals and everything looks so beautiful. The stars in the sky, the fish. Whoa. God is so creative. And God is so personal. God speaks. God talks. He's not a force in like unknown force. So how do we learn in Genesis chapter 1? A little peep at God. We learn His methods. His method is amazing. Geometric progression. Wow. If you study math, one of the things that amazed me is how fast 1 become 2 and 2 become 4, and before you know it, it's totally a huge number. Okay, so I hope today when you see Genesis 1, you will remember exactly what was done, and most of all, you have a little peep of this awesome God, His introduction to men like us.